What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Spencer playing Dragon Ball Z.
Budokai Tenkaichi 3. Did you forget the name of the game?
No.
You sure?
I just fell apart there for a second.
Okay, for sure. You just didn't. We were having like dialogue before this, and you stopped it to start the record.
Well, cause sometimes, well, it's a whole thing.
Only for you to fumble the first sentence.
Anyways. That's not the main reason we're playing this game. The main reason is we want to talk about Dragon Ball Z because
Dragon Ball Z has largely kind of fallen out of the contemporary anime discourse, I think.
You got Naruto, you got One Piece, and then Dragon Ball just kind of... People are looking badly upon the history of it, saying it's not a good anime. And it's very
strange because Dragon Ball is in a similar position that these other anime are, in that Dragon Ball is still ongoing, and like it's still adding to its story, like in the same way that Naruto and One Piece, all of them are. So it's like, but it's not talked about in that same way, where it doesn't seem to have an active, dedicated fan base among the modern anime fan.
These kids don't understand. So here's the thing, right? Like, it is still an ongoing story, but I think when people look back at Dragon Ball Z, they say it was like big boom punch pow, and that is what the anime boils down to. And
yeah,
that's not true.
Yeah, it's just like a really, like, there's just a prevailing perception around Dragon Ball that is just not really, like, it doesn't kind of stand weight, you know? Like, it's wrong. You are wrong.
When I look back, and I've recently tried to rewatch the show, I watched a lot of it, but, I went through the Saiyan saga, and I went through the Cell saga. Like, those two are, like, really good stories. Like, it's not just the powering up for 10 episodes, which is kind of part of the show. And if you watch Demon Slayer, very similar story structures when it comes to these like big set pieces at the end that take a really long time.
And that's what's interesting to me. It's that like a lot of these modern anime are like, you know, a lot of the ones that are fawned over, that are at the center of the public discourse, they take a lot of inspiration from Dragon Ball. Dragon Ball is archetypal for a lot of like modern shonen, I think. And so it's very just strange to see people either like ignore it. Like, it's fine if they ignore it to me, but it's like for you to kind of change the narrative of like how we got to this place, it feels weird to me that people legitimately don't want to give Dragon Ball the credit that it rightfully deserves as one of like the foundational building blocks for what we know modern shonen to be.
And like just anime in the United States too, like it literally was like the building block for like being okay or like normal to watch anime.
Do you think
in the US,
like, it's part of the reason why there's like this false perception is because we haven't gotten like a definitive, like there are so many like non-definitive versions of Dragon Ball like out there for people to watch, you know? There's the abridged, there's multiple different kinds of dubs, you know? And so I wonder if like people, because of that, like people have not been able to kind of see Dragon Ball in the way that like Toriyama meant for them to see it.
It's true. There are a lot of different versions of it. And also GT.
Yeah, like there are things that aren't canon.
Yeah, a lot of stuff that isn't. So I could see that, but Where do you think it came from? Like, where do you think it started? Like, the whole perception that this wasn't...
I'm trying to go Super Saiyan here, and it's just not letting me do it.
Maybe you have the wrong version of Goku.
I don't think... I think our config is not working here. Anyway, what were you saying?
Where do you think this perception came from? Like, where do you think it started?
I think it's a lot of just, like, recency bias. I think people want... For one, for the thing that they are currently watching and the thing that they discovered for themselves, I think that they want that to be validated as the best. And so you have people who are watching like newer age anime, and I love the new age anime. I have nothing against it. But like, we have to exist in the real world and where like these things actually kind of play a part in how, you know, stories get told and created and how people are inspired. So it's like, again, man, like, I see One Piece just came out with like a really controversial, not controversial, but like a really big chapter where a lot of stuff happens and people are like, you see people like poo-pooing on Dragon Ball and all of like, in retrospect. And it's like, dude, like, what is the point? What are we doing?
I don't know.
It doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense because it's like Dragon Ball legitimately inspired a lot of like characteristics about Luffy. Like it is literally like shown in the anime, like, or it's shown in the show. Like Oda dresses Luffy up like Roshi at some point in the story. Like it's all there. Like Dragon Ball is legitimately one of the most influential anime of all time. And I think that since people, I don't know, it doesn't really match the format or the kind of what you come to expect from a modern anime, in that it's like the pacing is kind of different. It's limited by the animation potential of its time. I think that might play a part in it just doesn't look like the anime that kids are watching these days.
No, it looks better. But no.
That's just you. Like, you'd hate anything that is like animation in an HD.
I know. I do. Let's see.
You also think it's like the passage of time too, because it's like there are all of these other anime that have like gone on consistently in that time, because it's like there was a point in time where Dragon Ball like was at the top of, you know, what Shonen Jump had going on. It was the biggest anime like in the world, you know, besides like Pokemon and stuff like that. But there was a certain point where there was just nothing happening on the Dragon Ball front. Other anime had to take over to kind of, you know, carry the industry on their backs. And then, you know, that became things like Naruto, things like One Piece. You know, so I think, you know, it's had to happen at a certain point, you know? It had to happen where, like, you know, if they weren't going to keep doing Dragon Ball forever and, you know, now they just might, like, just because you can make money off of it.
Yeah, like, it's true. The fact that it's possible now pretty much means it's going to happen. That's kind of how it works. But I still think, I like Dragon Ball Super.
And I think, like,
especially when you think about, like, we've never gotten a real proper sequel to Dragon Ball Z.
I think the way that Super is measured is, like, I think the standard changes when it comes to Dragon Ball, for sure. Like, I think the standard shifts when it's like, it has to, one, meet the standards of modern anime. Like, you know, in every way, it's got to have the hype moments, the music, all of that kind of stuff that, like, people have come to expect for some reason. But at the same time, like, there are 30 years worth of storytelling that precedes Dragon Ball Super that you have to be very careful with, and very kind of, like, if you're going to continue the story, a lot of people are going to be very invested in how you treat these different elements of the story. So they're fighting, like, you know, to continue the Dragon Ball series, they're fighting a war on all fronts, and it's just, like, I think it's difficult to kind of get to a point where you can feel comfortable, I think, when you are trying to win people over. That one, don't even watch Dragon Ball or have never watched Dragon Ball. You're trying to win those people over and get them to watch Dragon Ball, and you're trying to also entice the people who, you know, who have been watching since, you know, they were kids.
The one thing I also wanted to add about Dragon Ball Z was, like, we're all lying when saying that, like, some of these things, like, didn't capture every single one of our attention as a kid. Like, we were, like, waiting to see what happened. Like, when Trunks first showed up, like, those are iconic moments in anime. And now I feel like we've just kind of deafed those out. Like, that those moments really weren't as cool as they were. Like, no, dude, and the time, it was insane.
I think it's just because, like, there's a new generation of anime fans who have grown up where Dragon Ball was in that kind of complete, like, stasis period where nothing was really happening on the Dragon Ball front. And so, like, they grew up without, like, that presence, you know, and they think that just because, like, they're just reviving this old, dead show. It's like, that's not the case. Like, there's always been a demand for Dragon Ball stuff. People have always wanted more Dragon Ball stuff. It's just, like, the execution has always been kind of rough. in the immediate aftermath. And, you know, I think we're at a point now where it's kind of up for debate, you know, about, you know, what the state of Dragon Ball is like right now. I'm optimistic about it, but I think that's always been the point of contention. People are just trying to have, I think they have trouble looking at it like it's actually Dragon Ball when it is actually Dragon Ball. Like, Toriyama is penning this story.
It's true. How much longer do you think it's going to go on? Like, really? Like, when do you think there's going to be, like, the Super story's going to be told, and then there's going to be another show, like, after that?
It's just, like, there's, like, it's really hard to have a frame of reference, you know? Because what other show has been going on like this?
One Piece, I guess.
But it's like One Piece, I think, is fundamentally different in its storytelling. It's like, there has always been kind of like, I think One Piece is following like a pretty like general story outline, and has been for the majority of the run. And Oda has just changed things here and there to keep it going, you know? But Dragon Ball, they have like legitimately been like, okay, we're done. And then they have like tried to find reasons to come back, you know?
True. Yeah, that's Dragon Ball Z, you know what I mean? Great show.
I mean, I think that I don't know how to get the kids to recognize. Maybe it's Kai. Maybe it's Dragon Ball Z Kai. I think we need to make that more widely available. It's updated animation. It's all of the kind of
that's true.
Learn with the learned lessons of the past kind of, you know, snuffed out. I think that could be a really good way to introduce people to it. I don't know, man. It's just, it's weird. It's in a very similar place to where Naruto is, where it's like we're in a different kind of part of the story where, you know, they're not the same characters that we grew up with. And we're kind of trying to learn how to grapple with that.
It's true.
And so, I don't know. I think maybe in time, as it fades further, people will discover it more for what it really is and how it was meant to be interpreted, rather than how it existed in the contemporary kind of times that that they came out in.
I couldn't agree more with you. We'll see. I mean, I feel like if Dragon Ball Super can stick the landing, I feel like it could change the narrative of the way we discuss the show, just in general.
The people who are keeping up with it seem very optimistic and excited about the stuff that's going on. So I just want the anime to come back. I'm very excited about the future of Dragon Ball. I'm really excited to see this movie that's coming out. And hopefully, like, we get to see some of the, you know, we're in a unique position to where there's manga material for them to adapt for the first time when it comes to Dragon Ball Super, because they were running concurrently for most of this show's television run, you know, They were releasing the manga and anime at the same time. And so right now, we've let the manga get a head start on a couple of arcs. And so, it'll be interesting to see, you know, how the storytelling has changed when you kind of have a greater outline structure for your story for the anime team to work with.
Yeah, I do feel like that could make a really big difference.
I think, yeah, like, a lot of people's complaints about Dragon Ball Super were about how, you know, it didn't really feel these stories were connected and that there was like kind of like a big roadmap. But I think when we view it in hindsight, it'll look more like that because of, you know, the approach that they're taking now. But I think, you know, the way that they're headed, I'm really excited. I think that we're going to get into some interesting character dissections in the upcoming arcs, and I'm excited to see how they get adapted.
When does the movie come out? Do you know?
I think it comes out later this year. Dragon Ball Super Superhero.
Is that what they're calling it?
Everyone seems to think, okay, so let's get into a more general state of the Dragon Ball Union. It's a red ribbon. It's about the Red Ribbon Army. So, do you think we bring back Cell?
I hope not.
Makes you think that it isn't going to be Cell is my question. Like, is there any reason for you to think that it's not going to be Cell?
Do you really feel like we need that?
Maybe. I don't know. It's not up to me, really. So I'm just kind of like, that's my thing. Like, my approach to it is like, my approach to it is like, that's what they're doing. You know, I'm helpless to stop them. So it's like, it's my kind of, my interest in it is like, are they going to be able to make this work?
Yeah.
And so that's where I'm kind of viewing it from. And so I think bringing back the Red Ribbon Army first, instead of just being like, hey guys, Cell's back. I think that might be a better way of doing it and kind of looping it back into the greater
story. That's what story, the new movie's about?
The Red Ribbon Army, yeah. Like, they create, like, apparently the Red Ribbon Army is creating new androids, so.
Tried and true, man. Can't go wrong there.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it,
man. You think they're going to bring back the cowboy androids then?
Oh, that would be great.
And, like, make it canon, I guess?
I don't know.
Because they seem to be pretty...
There's a lot... They did it with Broly. Yeah, there's a lot to kind of... The Red Ribbon Army has kind of sprawled out in its own canon since, like, with GT and all of that stuff, so. I think... it may behoove them to kind of get definitive about the canon of the Red Ribbon Army, and I think that probably is what they're going to do with this movie.
That'd be kind of cool if they really do try to, like, retroactively, like, make all of those non-canon movies, like,
canonized. Oh, there are videos about why that cannot be.
No, I'm saying, because, like...
They contradict the canon in, like, really weird ways.
No, but I'm saying, like, the Broly movie essentially did that, like... Broly wasn't canon until that moment. I wonder if they're going to keep doing that.
And I think it kind of just depends on which. And I think that there is a lot of room because a lot of these characters are, like, beloved still. And they haven't kind of found their way into the Dragon Ball story organically.
Oh, fuck.
Raditz is whooping your ass, man.
Fuck. Controller's, like, going in and out. It's making it very difficult to play the game.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, I think there's a lot of cause to be excited. I would like to see them, yeah, canonize some certain characters. What if they could canonize a character from the movies? Who would you pick?
BoJack, maybe.
I was thinking BoJack too. Especially since, like, this specific story,
such an iconic villain. I feel like
it seems to be Gohan centered in some form of fashion. Pan is involved, so it's like. I think if you kind of sprawl Gohan off on this little mini arc, I think bringing back BoJack would be a really, really cool way.
He's really one of the, like, in the movies, I kind of put him back over the edge, you know?
Yeah, you could do some kind of, like, roundabout storytelling with Gohan in that way. I think that would be dope.
All right, I'm just going to call the...
All right, the BoJack movie coming in 2025, guys.
Guaranteed.
You heard it here first.
We're going to talk with the creators of Dragon Ball, and it's just pen on paper at this point.
We'll get the call in. Yeah, we'll put the call in.
Cross our T's, dot our I's, and that's pretty much how it goes. But yeah, any final thoughts on Dragon Ball Z?
Put some respect on it, man. That's all I want. I just want it to get its proper due.
Give me what I want.
Yes, indeed.
Yeah, I agree. All right, guys. That's going to do it for today's video, and I'll see you guys next time.